Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1899, Resize Rectangle, based on formula cell results. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. Today's question sent in by YouTube. I've created a shapes rectangle in Excel and can edit the size, height and width, but I would like this to automatically resize based on these formula results. Is that possible? It's macro. All right, yes, it's possible, but you have to use a VBA macro. So in order to use a VBA macro, a couple of things. Alt-T-M-S, make sure that you are not set to the highest security there, otherwise you can't use macros. Also, if your file is stored as xlsx, which is very, very common, you have to do file save as and save as xlsm or xlsb. xlsx is not allowed to have macros, all right? First thing we have to do is figure out the name of this. It looks like it's rectangle one, but you know what? I'm lazy. I'm going to record a macro. It's going to be called How to Resize. Stored in this workbook, and I'm just going to select the shape, and I'm going to resize it, and then stop recording. That way I changed both the height and the width. Alt F8 to take a look at that code, How to Resize, Edit. All right, so here's how they refer to it, activesheet.shapes.rangeArray_rectangle1. And then, they got me. They actually used the scale height and scale width methods, not what I expected them to do, but at least I know now the name of how they refer to this, activesheet.shapes.rangeArray_rectangle1.select, although we don't actually have to select. Now, the trick is, as this worksheet recalculates, you want to resize the rectangle. So the code can't live here on module 1 or module 2. Instead, the code has to live on the worksheet. So in the Project Explorer here, I double click on sheet 1. From the top left drop down, choose worksheet, and they automatically choose selection change, but I want to open the top right drop down and say no. I want this macro to run every time we calculate. All right, and I'll paste in some code here. So this is from the recorded macro, although I took off the dot select and I added width before it. Anytime you have width and end width, all of the other lines don't have to say activesheet.shapes.range. You can just leave all that off and just put a dot. So the dot says, hey, go back and append this property to the end of everything in the width. So I'm changing the width to be my A2 value, change to the height to be my A1 value, end width, end sub. I can actually get rid of this now. And that little recorded macro that I did, that was just a little tester. We can get rid of that. If I want to, I can right-click and remove module 2. So we just have that little bit of code. And then to test it out, this is a RAM between variable up here. So every time that I enter something in a new cell, that will calculate and the shape will automatically update. All right, cool idea. Simple little bit of code to get it done. Hey again, if you happen to be watching this on July 23rd or 24th, you have until, I think, 8 o'clock tonight on the 24th for Minda Teresa's awesome, amazing Excel dashboard course, or until July 31st for 50% off Fast Excel. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast with Mr. Excel.